Greetings, Greywitch here. So now we're back with part three, Fatal Incursion. So let's start this up.
Okay, head over to Stab City. Time to get stabbing.
Alright, so let's head to Stab City. Alright, so when I get here, this is something I do. You don't have to do this, but it could be beneficial, especially if you have explosive rounds for your Mark II sniper rifle. Now, I just have the heat scope. I forgot to put the things on there, but I'm just going to sit up here and just snipe out some of the guys, just thin it out a little bit. Now, if I had the explosive rounds, I could turn off the heat scope and hit some of these targets that I'm supposed to take out, which are basically the bikes and the vans and tankers and anything else in there that you can pretty much take out. Because the goal of this mission is to take out as much damage as possible. Or to make as much damage as possible. So whenever you get ready to, just mosey on in there and start destroying stuff. So when I came in, I just came right in the front door. And you don't have to use explosives like I am. There's barrels by pretty much everything that you need to blow up or anything like that. And you can just shoot whatever it is you're at. Like right here, the motorcycle. It doesn't take as many bullets as normal. There you go. Just watch your six and keep moving. Now what I like to do is I like to work my way around in here from behind all of the trailers from the backside, and then I'll just pop up when I need to destroy some stuff. It seems to work quite well. And all of these barrels that are spread out around here, you see like one that's blown up right there in front of me. There's another one back here on the stage I'm getting ready to shoot. Shoot those because they'll start fires and it'll also destroy other stuff around you, and it helps you get the property meter up to where you need it to go. As you see right here in the lower right hand corner, there's a meter that just disappeared, and now the mission's over. Well, this part of the mission. Alright, so we're gonna head across to the fishery where we were earlier. And this time, I'm gonna attack from the correct side. So there's some guys that were chasing me. Let's eliminate these guys real quick. Now we're gonna go in here and we're gonna have to steal 10 big old things of medicinal stuff. Some medicinal rectangles. Alright, so come around here. There's gonna be guys all over the place. That one, get that guy right there. Make sure you got your armor and your snacks up. Maybe some guys around this fan. Don't be afraid to use explosives, but remember, those rounds will bounce back at you. And the first box is right here. See it sitting there on the table, right there. Take out these few guys real quick. And, you know, I've had people ask me, they're like, why do you shoot just randomly all the time? And what I do that because it will cause some of the people to show up on the map by shooting, and it just helps to bring the bad guys out, because it'll make them shoot at me, or sometimes I'll just shoot in their general area just to make them jump behind cover and stuff like that. So if you see me shooting for random reasons, that's basically what I'm doing, is I'm trying to find out where everybody is. Because the little red dots disappear on the map. I'm trying to make them show back up. By triggering them to move. Alright, so run up here. There's going to be a bunch of guys down here in this little lower area. But the area we got to go first is right behind me. Right in here. There's two more of those medicinal rectangles. Right there. Okay, so come back out here. Make sure the guys don't get you. There's one on the corner of that building that's a pain in the ass to get to. There's a whole bunch of them down there. So, keep the old alley-oop. This will make it a little easier. Now, I haven't destroyed any of these packages yet, so I don't know if you can. So I would be careful with the explosives. I don't know if they can be destroyed. but I wouldn't get too crazy with them, just in case. Alright, so if you see right across me where it says Miller's Boat Shop, that's where we're going. We gotta go to the back of that building. So we're gonna run across over here, and we're gonna get Dax to call us. Now I'll trigger this next part. Ooh, rank up. There's a guy right there that I cannot get who shot me like 5 times. Okay. So now we're over here. More guys are gonna spawn. Up on the hill. And as you come around this corner, there's a guy right here in the back. Drop him, or he'll get you. And then we go to the door. And there's 2 guys as soon as you come in here. There's one with a baseball bat, and there's another one with a pistol. The one with the baseball bat will be coming first. And there's the pistol guy. I shot him to death in the feet. Alright, there's one. There's another one. And put on some armor. Get on out of here. Okay, so now let's move around this way. We can go back out the same way we were. Let's find out where some people are. Put that one right there. Alright. So now we're going to go down to where that lost band is on the corner. Right to my right. There's 2 more packages there. There's one on this little thing and one right there. Now go behind this. Get these guys that are coming up behind you. Or in front of you. There's going to be a guy coming up behind you on the docks. Which is going to be our escape route. So make sure you get that guy. There he is right there. Let me lock onto him. Oh, down. Now we're going to move this way. There's one more package we've got to get before we head down the docks. There's that guy that shot me like 10 times. He's finally dead. We're going to head over here. There's going to be a boat with a package in it. Right there. Oh. Make sure these guys don't sneak up behind me. There's one trying to. Right down there. There he is. We got a brother down. And he is down. Alright. So right there in the boat, there's going to be a guy in front of that van. I don't think he can hit me. So we're going to grab that. Head on back the way we just came. Now, get that guy. Anybody else who's trying to sneak up on us. The guy over here. Use the old shotgun. If I can get him with that. Nope, it did not work. That did. Alright, so now we're gonna head on the dock. Come down here, we're gonna jump in this plane. But first, grab those. And steal that plane. And my phone's gone. Now, if you haven't flown one of these, it's not too bad. Because you got to land it in the little canal right in the city. So, if you're not good at flying, this mission might suck for you. But you definitely want to keep this thing up high off the ground so the guys on the ground don't shoot at you. Because this vehicle does have a health meter, as you can see right there in the bottom right-hand corner. You want to come down here, avoid as many obstacles as possible, and land in the water. As I landed twice and skid up onto the land, and this same thing happened both times. It would not let me go any further forward. You can see I'm trying to push on it right here, and it just, nothing. It won't let me go forward. So what I eventually had to do was hold the gas, the reverse down, and just go back and forth with the wings, trying to get it to slowly wiggle its way backwards. And then I finally got back in the water, and then it just started acting normal again. But this happened to me twice. So I hope they fix this. And once you get back in the water, it goes perfect. But I couldn't get the gear to go up or down or anything. It was like I was pressed right up against a wall. And then come down here and cutscene catches. And the mission's over. And that's it. I'll show you the payout, and then I'll see you in the next one.